Hi, everybody. David Junga, pulmonaryrehab.com. Hello, how's it going? I want to talk to you about the big elephant in the room. You don't even know what it is, but I'm going to tell you it's there. The level of oxygen in your body is a big issue. A lot of people are in denial when they put these pulse oxes on their fingers and they're reading below 90, below 92 even, which I don't like, but okay, if you have to. It's damaging your body. You are actively killing heart tissue, brain tissue, and lung tissue. And you're gonna say, okay, oh my God, now you're scaring the hell out of me. What am I gonna do about this? It's really simple. You want to get a pulse ox, and you wanna put it on your finger, and you want to measure what your oxygen level and what your heart rate is during your average day. So you know when I climb stairs, it's dropping. I need to bump up my oxygen a little more. Talk to your doctor about that. You might say I go out to the mailbox, my oxygen's dropping. So now we wanna know what things you are doing that are making your oxygen drop, because we don't wanna do any more damage. You already have some lung damage, why make it worse? Voluntarily through oxygen deprivation. You don't want that. It's called hypoxia. You don't want that. So if you're hypoxic, if you're watching this and you're feeling like your oxygen is a little low, and it could be, check your finger. Once it starts to go below 88, that's when the potential for damage starts. And the lower it goes below 88 and the longer it stays down there is when damage occurs. So don't get crazy. If it drops down to 88 for a second and drops back up, you're okay. If you're living your day and it's 85, there's a problem, especially if you have the luxury of having oxygen. Use it. The way I look at oxygen is the same way an orthopedist looks at a cast. Your leg is broken. Okay, you're gonna put a cast on it to help it heal, to help everything get back to where it needs to be, right? That's what you want. You don't wanna just take the cast off and go, oh, I'll just take it off and walk out to the mailbox. Then your leg's gonna re-break. You don't want that. So I want you to check the numbers on your finger. I want you to look at the other part, which is your heart rate. How hard is your heart working to maintain that level of oxygen? Ideally, we want everybody 92 or higher. Some people are 90 or higher. That's what their doctor said is acceptable. Talk to your doctor. Everybody's different. I'm making a general statement. You have to take responsibility and accountability for your health. Talk to your doctor. Open that communication, that dialogue. Have them set parameters that are safe for you. If you don't know, talk to them, and then you can get in touch with us. I'd be more than happy to try to help you. If you have oxygen, please use it. We see so many people coming in with portable concentrators and they're not getting enough oxygen. And it breaks my heart because they're walking in and they're carrying this thing around with them, and it's really actually setting up a false sense of security because they think that they're doing the right thing and they're actually harming themselves. And they're wondering why they keep getting worse, why their shortness of breath is increasing, why their muscles are getting weaker, why they have muscular pain. All this goes together, okay? So please wear your oxygen, check your numbers, get a pulse ox. They're not that expensive. And it's well worth it that you took care of yourself for a change, because you deserve it and you're worth it. Excellent. Have a wonderful day. I'm really proud of you. Thank you so much for taking the time to listen to me. It really means a lot to all of us here. And I hope you have a wonderful day. Thanks. Goodbye.